are discussing linking innovation platforms with action to improve rainwater management. We had a set of four questions. The first one was, who should facilitate such platforms? What would be the entry points, whether to have the innovation platforms around thematic areas like markets or NRM? Where would the resources come from? And how to deal with the power relations that exist in such platforms? In terms of facilitation of the platforms, we had a discussion around how to ensure that the platforms are sustainable and therefore the need to have local champions within the Warrender that facilitate these platforms, but also to try and build on existing activities or existing processes that are going on at Warrender level, especially when you think about what would be the incentives for people to want to facilitate the innovation platforms. The other issue we discussed around that question was the fact whether it's other stakeholders that are joining our agenda, or we can actually join the agenda of the Warrender, and therefore the issue will be if rainwater management is already happening at Warrender level, would our input then be changing the processes around how this is done, in which case we're joining the Warrender's agenda or the Department of Agriculture's agenda and trying to influence how that is done, in which case the facilitation then is on the onus of the Warrender. But then there are issues around capacities and how this will play up with the power relations between the Warrender administration and farmers, etc. On entry points, the main discussion was around how to combine short-term gains for farmers with the more longer-term activities around improving the landscape and the ecosystem and so on, and how we use a process for identifying key entry points that sort of takes advantage of these two. We used an example of what Josie talked about, a site where one of the major issues is marketing of onions. How do you use market as an entry point and then move from market to ensuring productivity, and then productivity directly links into how you manage the water that is used for onions. In terms of resources, we need to tap into existing resources, but recognizing that if the agenda is the agenda that's bought into by other stakeholders, that the project probably would need to put in the initial resources, but based on how engaged people are on the agenda, to what extent it's meeting their needs and priorities, that we might start seeing more investments into the innovation platforms from the other actors. Power relations, we talked about, do we want to start with the innovation platforms? Do we want to start with a community engagement that then leads into the innovation platforms? So the advantage of starting with a community engagement is that when you have farmers representing other farmers in the innovation platforms, that they actually do have a community agenda and it's not their individual agendas, but also how to use existing networks, user groups, cooperatives, in order to have that representation. But the fact that in order to overcome these power relations, there would need to be a lot of capacity building for farmers as well to be able to engage in the IP process. Thank you.